I am Assistant Professor S.V. Shetai from Agricultural Engineering Department. This session is based on practical number 6. Okay, now let's see the practical number 6. Practical number 6, which is include the furrow openers and different types of furrow openers that is particularly used in the seed drill, okay, for opening a furrow. Okay, then the seed drill, the seed tube conducts the seed from the feed mechanism into the boot from where they fall into the furrows. Okay, now there are different types of furrow openers used. So first one, that is a shovel type, then show type, and last one, that is disc type. In disc type, again there are two types: single disc, double disc. Okay, now let's see the first type, that is shovel type. Shovel type furrow opener are widely used in seed drills, and there are three of shovels in use. So first one, that is reversible shovel. It looks like this. It has both pointed ends, so it is reversible shovel type. Okay, then single point shovel. In this type, it has only single point to the shovel. And then next type, that is spear point shovel. Okay, it looks like this. Okay, now shovel type openers are best suited for stony or root infested fields. Okay, and these shovels are bolted to the flat iron shank at the point where the boots are fitted, which carry the end of the seed tubes. Okay, so in order to prevent shock loads due to the obstruction, springs are provided, and it is easy in construction, cheaper and easily repairable, and it is very common with usual seed drill. Now the next type, that is show type. It works well in thrashy soils where the seed beds are not smoothly prepared. Okay, so then they are made from two flat pieces of steel welded together to form a cutting edge, and it looks like this. Okay, and it is specially suited for black cotton soil, and a show is made up of carbon steel having the minimum carbon content, that is about 0.5%, with a minimum thickness of 4 mm. Okay, the next type, that is disc type. Okay, there are two types: single disc type and double disc type. Single disc type furrow openers looks like this, and this is the double disc type furrow openers. Okay, now let's know about single disc type. It is the furrow opener consisting of one concave disc, and disc type furrow opener are found suitable where the plant debris or thrash mulches are used. Okay, then it consists of curved disc made of hardened steel, and it is set at angle, which while operating shift the soil to one side, making a small ridge. Okay, in such a way that angle is set. Okay, then the disc is kept clean by two scrapers, one toe shaped at a convex side and one T shaped at a concave side. Okay, so this is the convex side, this is the concave side. Okay, then the disc penetrates well in the soil, cut all the trashes and clods in the field. It works in sticky soils also, but the discs are costly and maintenance work is a bit difficult. Okay, then double disc type. In double disc type furrow opener, there are two flat discs set at angle to each other, and the disc open a clean furrow and leave a small ridge in the center. Then the disc the seeds are dropped between the two discs, providing a more accurate placement, and it is suitable for again thrashy lands and seed drills attached with the tractors having high speeds usually use this type of furrow opener. And the furrow opener consists of tine, shovel, seed tube, boot for the seed and fertilizers, and shovel is made from carbon steel having the 0.5% and minimum thickness about 4 mm. Then seed tube is a tube which carries the seed from the metering device to the boot, and seed tubes are provided at the lower end of the feed cups, and they conduct seeds from the feed cups to the furrow lines through the suitable boots and furrows openers lowest line through a suitable boots and furrow openers. Okay, then the minimum diameter of the seed and fertilizer tube is about 25 mm, and boot, it is the part of the sowing machine which conveys the seeds or fertilizers from the delivery tube to the furrow, and it is bolted or welded to the tine. Okay, now this part of field effective field capacity, that is from the practical number 12. Now let's see the effective field capacity. It is defined as the actual area covered by the implement based on its total time consumed and its width, and it is calculated as EFC is equal to area divided by total width of the implement. It's a total time required. Okay, now A means area covered in hectare and T means time required in hour. Okay, after that, theoretical field capacity, it is the rate of field coverage of an implement based on 100% of the time at the rated speed covering 100% of its rated width, and it is calculated at TFC is equal to W into S divided by 10. And TFC means theoretical field capacity, W means width of the implement in meter, and speed is the speed of operation in kilometer per hour. Okay, then field efficiency, it gives an indication of time lost in the field and failure to utilize the working of the implement, and it is the ratio of effective field capacity to the theoretical field capacity and usually expressed in percentage. And the formula for the field efficiency, this is okay. Now this part is completed here. So thank you for listening.